2020 was supposed to be a big year for entertainment in Ottawa. Pearl Jam and Justin Bieber were coming. We were finally going to see the Broadway hit Hamilton. There was a new Cirque du Soleil show on the calendar, and Bluesfest was anticipating its biggest year ever, with a killer lineup that included Rage Against the Machine, Alanis Morissette, and Marshmello. The year got off to such a promising start. We were dazzled by the Royal Winnipeg Ballet's million-dollar co-production of The Wizard of Oz, and enthralled by a spectacular new take on the never-ending story. Indie rockers Half Moon Run played their first headlining arena show at TD Place, and it was a thrill to be there. The clubs were rockin', and the Winter Jazz Festival was a blast. Then the pandemic hit in March, and there was a clean sweep. Every day brought a new postponement or cancellation. Musicians who lost their gigs immediately turned to live streaming, and the National Arts Centre jumped into it too, partnering with Facebook Canada to come up with Canada Performs, a program that provided funding to artists for their live stream efforts. Jim Cuddy kicked it off and it became a hit, ultimately helping close to 700 artists across the country. The folks at RBC Bluesfest also made things happen, organizing a scaled-down, drive-in version of the summer festival that featured headliners Sam Roberts and Tim Hicks performing to an audience of people in their cars. Concert promoter Live Nation set up a big stage at Wesley Clover Parks and hosted a bunch of drive-in events there, from rock concerts to movie screenings. There were other creative ideas to provide COVID-proof entertainment, including a dinner and show series that had the artists playing on a boat on the Rideau Canal across from an audience seated on the terrace of the NAC. The Festival of Small Halls was able to present safely in-person shows that were taped and then repurposed as part of an online edition of City Folk, along with remote performances by headliners Jason Isbell and Steve Earle. Most of the other festivals too, whether music or film, also went for virtual editions this year. While these endeavors provided glimmers of hope throughout the year, there's no sugarcoating the toll the pandemic has taken on the performing arts industry. Ottawa has already lost venues, including Sinkhole and Prest, and the Bytown Cinema has announced its closing at the end of the year. The clubs are hanging on by a thread, some selling t-shirts or crowdfunding to make ends meet, and musicians are starting to flog their instruments to raise some cash. So now what? Bluesfest is promising the same killer lineup for next year with Rage, Alanis, and Marshmello, but still, even with a vaccine, there are no guarantees of a summer festival season. It's going to be a long road back.